die if she knew. I'm Pezzhead, and I'm a artist, an alternative artist. Kind of started in my head. I got frustrated and wanted to make music on my own, so I started making music on my own. It all started kind of in my head, but like a lot of the ideas that are from me, kind of thing. I know it seems like an obvious answer, but like.
With extremely unique music, over the past 4 years, Pezzhead has amassed a large discography of 6 albums. There's been Red Turtle Dove, Freeborn Grove, Trends, Radio Ghost, a collaboration with Biv, The Embellished Mud, and The Embellished Mud Embellished Version, serving as a deluxe edition to the album. In an interview with Ride, he was described as one of those artists that just fuses elements of metal, trap, hip-hop, electronica, and more to create an awe-inspiring Frankenstein sound that's frenzied and fueled by raw emotion. And, with his 7th album releasing at the end of this year, titled Blue Turtle Dove, he doesn't show any signs of slowing down anytime soon.
A lot of, like, aesthetically, it's like films. So my favourite film is probably 28 Days Later, by Danny Boyle, and if you watch that film, I think you'll understand why. I like kind of gritty horror films that aren't like horror films, they're more like dramas. So I get a lot of my aesthetic from that. I think a lot of it's emotion and that, I don't know, I just like distorted like visuals and stuff isn't like perfect, I guess, but it's a specific vibe. I try to like create my own version of that, so a lot of my inspiration comes inward. So with music, it's a lot of inward stuff.
Yeah.
Outward, like I listen to a lot of music, but I think growing up listening to metal was a big part of it, and it's more like just because with metal you have like worlds created in music and stuff like that. So I like the depth of that kind of music. There's a lot of depth and like color to that music, but I also like experimental rap music as well. I think there's a lot of depth to that shit as well. So I say like JPEG. Peggy, where you been at? Getting all this promo. When it comes to money, bet these niggas is a no-show. I've been out in Bed-Stuy, chilling with my feet up, laughing at these Sam Cloud niggas dropping. Tyler. Kanye. Death Grips. A lot of my music is just getting shit done. And I think a lot of it is also like being like, I ain't a part of anything really, so I have to make my own shit. Like I'm from a part of the country where it's not like easy to be a rapper.
Pezzhead is actually only one of 3 current projects being worked on by the same person, the other two being The Summit. And Fall Into The Cut. In which Pezzhead plays guitar and also sings vocals. So during the interview, I got a chance to ask, how does he tackle these 3 projects differently as far as writing, producing, everything?
I'd say like with Pezzhead, it's very like, it's like Pezzhead was the beginning, I guess. So everything I used to do was all Pezzhead. So I used to do rock music, I used to do like dark shit, and I also used to do like experimental stuff. I feel like with Pezzhead, it's more like I kind of just do whatever the fuck I want. I don't really give a fuck about what people think about it. So I'll be doing that. And then it's like my inner child kind of thing.
Yeah.
The summit is like full concept. So I have like a concept that I've written that used to be a part of Pezzhead. That's like about Freeborn Grove and New Hive and like this world I created in my head. And then putting that onto paper. And I feel like with the summit, it's like that's where I want to bring a lot of the darkness and the color and make this like really contrived concept music that's like really like progressive but electronic. And I want to be strict with that, and I feel like with the summit it's given me freedom to just like be a bit more, I would say dark, but like I feel like less ego, because Pezzhead, I feel like there's quite a lot of ego behind it.
Summit's
empty. With Falling to the Cart, it's more a group thing because I've got two other people in the band. So we all write stuff together. And I more often than not, I do be taking a back seat. I am like a producer and like songwriter in the band, but a lot of the time I don't really write the lyrics. I really value it. Like I still do fucking like a lot in the band. I'm the engineer and producer and a songwriter, so I put the songs together, but I still just like to take it back. And it's just a nice break, and it's my roots.
Yeah.
So I like, rock music's metal is my roots, and I'm a guitar player. So I just, that's it's like home for me, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's comfort, I guess. I feel like this is kind of hard to answer because I don't know if my stuff deserves, I feel like my stuff gets what it deserves to an extent. I do obviously wish that I was more like, had like a lot more success out of it, but I feel like that is gonna come with time. I think the stuff that deserves more recognition is yet to come. That's what I'd say. But to answer it like actually, like honestly, I guess I'd say Freeborn Grove. I wish people like turned heads a bit more. It's just quite an interesting project, and if you listen to it, it's like, that's where a lot of the sounds came from. But it's like, it doesn't sound like nothing that I make now, really, but I hold it dear to my heart. You know what I mean? I think it's become less kind of like trap and rap orientated and more like kind of like a new kind of style. But I'm kind of falling back into doing like some rap stuff. So I'm not sure. I feel like one of the things is that's changed over time is just my ability to like make dope stuff. I don't know. Like maybe my production's just gotten a bit better.
Yeah.
I think I've become more positive and less angry, and more like trying to be a bit more like, especially with Pezzhead, I'm just trying to be a bit more positive, but not, I don't know how to, I feel like with Embellished Mud it was like a bit of a fuckery because I didn't really care about what people thought about it. I don't even know who made that album, man. Like I don't know who the fuck made it. I like, do you know what, like I feel like I'm surprised people more now than I did in the past, I guess. Anywhere, find it on mainly Spotify. You can find me in New Hive, you know what I mean? Well, I'm not there anymore. You can find me in Brighton. I'll be doing shows in Brighton. You can find me anywhere nowadays. I'm all up down the country. But if you want to listen to my music, Spotify, just go to Spotify. I'm on SoundCloud as well, but I'm trying to build up the Spotify because that's what pays me. Not that I care about money, but when you like kind of fucking don't have a specific place to live anymore, you need money.
Yeah.
But yeah. Is that good?